And I'm Laurel Reason.
And welcome to Cabarrus This Week. And this week, hey, we're at the Kannapolis Cruise Inn.
Oh my goodness, look at all these vehicles.
Oh man, there are lots of cars. Laurel's going to tell you all about that in the show. And we've got a lot of other information on today's show, so grab that pen and paper so you can write that contact info down. Hey, if you missed something, don't worry about it. We give a web address and an email address at the end of the show.
Parking is hard to come by on the streets of Kannapolis on the second Saturday of the month. A classic car to modern hot rods and everything in between fills the streets. CTW is here on the beautiful afternoon among lots of great looking cars and fabulous vendors. The Cabarrus Events Association has hosted the cruise-ins for the last 5 years, and they average 600 cars and drivers each month. That's a lot.
That is a lot.
Don't have a ride to show off to the crowd? Bring the family for a picnic or a chair to people watch. The downtown merchants will have out their wares, so shopping is encouraged. The cruise-ins take place the second Saturday of each month, March through November, from 3 to 8 p.m. For more information, call 704-932-3808 or visit www.cabarrusevents.org. The next cruise-in will be October 11.
I tell you, this is such a fun place. I mean, I remember I grew up in Lincoln County. We used to cruise around the Court Square. I should have come over here because they used to call this Idiot Square.
Yeah,
Idiot's Loop, which would really work for me. I should have driven over here. Okay.
And looped around with the other idiots.
That's right. All having a good time. That's it. Now, Lego recently became the top-selling toy in the U.S. You can have fun, play with it. You can build just about anything with it.
Legos.
Oh yeah. From buildings to toy cars, even robots. That's pretty cool. Now, and then, you know, the other thing that's neat, once you finish, you can just take it all apart and start all over again. Now, the Kannapolis Library wants you to build something on Wednesday, September the 24th, beginning at 4 p.m. That's ages 4 to 12. Can use their imaginations and dig into Legos. Then at 5:30, teens and adults, that's when I can come in there, and are invited to create something out of this world, like space habitats and creatures for Legos in space.
Legos in space.
There we go. Okay. For more information on Dig Into Legos and Legos in Space, taking place on Wednesday, September the 24th, beginning at 4 p.m. for ages 4 to 12, and 5:30 for teenage and adults at the Kannapolis Library, simply call 704-920-1180 or visit cabarruscounty.us/library.
The brand new Opry Bluegrass Show returns to Davis Theater on Thursday, September 25th at 7:30 p.m. for a performance filled with high-energy traditional bluegrass. The brand new Opry is hosted by local bluegrass virtuoso Jeff Winnington and features an all-star lineup of outstanding musicians. You're guaranteed a night of toe-tapping fun. Tickets are $15 online at the Davis Theater box office Monday through Friday, 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. or by phone. For more information on the brand new Opry playing Thursday, September 25th, 7:30 p.m. at Davis Theater, call 704-920-2753 or visit cabarrusartscouncil.com.
Now that was a real car sound right there.
Oh my God, that was loud. In fact, I thought I saw people jump back.
That's the way a car should be. Okay. Now, never thought you might need to change a job again? Well, changing careers in midlife, possibly? Well, Rowan Cabarrus Community College is offering a free Looking for Work at 50 Plus workshop this Thursday on September 25th from 1 to 2:30 p.m. And that's at the R3 Center in Kannapolis. Now, you don't want to miss this. Got all kinds of great opportunities to address specific concerns about being over 50 and looking for work. And I know how that is because my business closed down, and at 50 years old, I was looking for a job. And then they made the mistake and hired me for this one. So, you know, so you can learn how to get a job, okay? Now, topics include looking for a job in today's workplace, promoting yourself to employers, and ways to build your confidence as you search for your next position.
If you lose your job, you can come to CTW.
That's right. There you go. So for more information on looking for work at 50 Plus Workshop, taking place this week on Thursday, September the 25th at R3 Center, 200 West Avenue in Kannapolis, just call 704-216-7201 or visit rccc.edu/events and type in 50 Plus into the search bar.
Whether you are in the beginning stages of planning your wedding or looking for that elegant final touch, you'll walk away inspired at the Carolina Bridal Fair. Wedding professionals are on site to answer your questions and help your wedding vision become a reality. The fair takes place Sunday, September 28th from 12 to 5 p.m. at the Cabarrus Arena. Tickets are $10 and can only be purchased at the door. Registered brides and grooms who attend the show are eligible to win over $20,000 in door prizes and receive $1,000 in Carolina Bridal Bucks to use toward your wedding. Brides must register and you must attend in order to be eligible. The first 800 attendees receive a bridal goodie bag.
Ooh, there you go.
For more information or to register for the Carolina Bridal Fair taking place September 28th from 12 to 5 p.m. at the Cabarrus Arena, call 704-920-3976 or visit carolinabridalfair.com.
And I can tell you from experience, my oldest daughter just got married this past week, and that would have been a really good place to go to, because the logistics on all that were a lot more overwhelming, you know, than producing a television show. So anyway, but it was a lot of fun. Okay.
Which now, is harder, a television show or a wedding?
I tell you what, it's tight.
Six of one, half dozen of the
other. That's it. Now, Diamond Rio won their first Grammy for Christian music. Today, they'll be heard across the country, Christian music, all the airways. Now, they're coming to the Cabarrus Arena on Friday, September 26th. And you might have heard their hit, Meet in the Middle, where it debuted in 1991. And Diamond Rio became the very first group in the history of country music to debut a single in the number one spot. That's pretty good. Now, if that wasn't impressive enough, since then, the band sold over 10 million albums, earning 3 platinum, 5 gold records, winning the Country Music Association Vocal Group of the Year 4 times, as well as netting 2 Academy of Country Music Awards and 13 Grammy nominations.
Wow, impressive.
That's a resume.
Mm-hmm.
Now, tickets for general admission only cost $26 per person. For more information or to purchase tickets to the Diamond Rio concert taking place on Friday, September the 26th, beginning at 8 p.m., at the Cabarrus Arena, call 704-920-3976 or visit CabarrusArena.com.
David, did you know that the first speck of gold was not found in California?
You know, I had heard that somewhere.
It was found right here in Cabarrus County. We're taking a trip back in time to the gold rush era and try your hand at panning for gold. This year celebrates the 25th Gold Hill Founders Day, and it starts with a parade at 10 a.m. on Saturday, September 27th at the old mining town of Gold Hill. Once known as the richest mining town east of the Mississippi, and today the town is home to a park, trail, and tours of the sites and landmarks. Gold Hill Founders Day is a family-friendly event packed with music, parades, a Little Miss and Mr. Gold Hill competition, Civil War living history encampment, blacksmiths, woodcarvers, tours, and hay rides. For more information on Gold Hill Founders Day, Saturday, September 27th, call 704-267-9439 or visit www.historicgoldhill.com.
Now, you know, Laurel, one of the first shows we did together was at North Cabarrus Park. And we were stomping around in the creek.
Yes, we were
panning for gold.
Gold.
That's right. Well,
we
now,
didn't find any. That's why we came back here.
That's right. Now, if you play with bugs or love watching them and creep and crawl around your path, okay, then come to North Cabarrus Park, because you can join the rangers out there for a creek stomp, which is it is a whole lot of fun. I've done that, and it's fun stomping around in the creek. Now, they use these nets, and you can pick up these little insects and little animals and all kinds of little cool stuff that's in the creek and stomp all around. So if you like doing that, which it is a lot of fun, beside your face, okay.
Bugs? You didn't tell me there were bugs.
Yeah, there were bugs in there. Okay.
I knew there was gold, not bugs.
On Saturday, October the 4th at 11 a.m., can learn from the park ranger what the county does to keep our park waters clean. So for more information on the creek stomp taking place on Saturday, October the 4th at 11 a.m. in North Cabarrus Park, just call 704-920-2703 or visit cabarruscounty.us/reserve partner and use the key phrase, creek stomp.
Creek stomp.
Now, creek stomp.
The John Brown Quintet, an all-star group of North Carolina jazz musicians, brought down the house when they played at the Davis in 2010. And number 8 on the Jazz Week chart. You can once again see them take the stage of the Davis Theater on Friday, October 3rd at 8 p.m. Tickets are $36 and can be purchased online or over the phone through the Davis Theater box office. The John Brown Quintet specializes in music from the time-honored bebop and hard bop jazz eras and bring new life to some of the best-known classics in the Great American Songbook. For more information on the John Brown Quintet playing the Davis Theater on Friday, October 3rd at 8 p.m., call 704-920-2753 or visit CabarasArtsCouncil.com.
Now, if you love to kind of wrap up on a cold winter's night in a blanket or a quilt, well, you'll love, maybe you love quilting your own or just kind of looking at some amazing ones. Well, the 2014 Splash of Color Quilt Show is a great event you got to check out. Show runs from October 3rd and 4th at the Cabarrus Arena. Now, not only you'll be able to check out all kind of numerous quilts, but you'll learn how to make them. Oh, there'll be all kind of free demonstrations and silent auction, a white elephant booth, quilt raffle, and great door prizes. Now, a one-day pass costs $6 and a two-day pass is only $8. Parking is $5 per vehicle. For more information on the Splash of Color Quilt Show, Friday, October 3rd from 9 a.m. till 5 p.m. and on Saturday, October 4th from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m., visit CabarrusArena.com.
You know, David, some days we all need our very own fairy godmother. I wonder if the fairy godmother is related to the Frank Lisk fairies. Have you heard about the Frank Lisk fairies?
I have not.
Well, come out to Frank Lisk Park on Saturday, October 11th at 11 a.m. to learn the story of the Frank Lisk fairies and build some houses on the Fairy House Trail in Nature's Niche for them to live. For more information on the Fairy House event taking place Saturday, October 11th at 11 a.m. at Frank Lisk Park, call 704-920-2703 or visit CabarrusCounty.us/reserve partner and use key phrase Fairy House.
Now, you want to invite your inner Picasso to art, art, and more art. Now, that's going to be at the Harrisburg Town Hall Municipal Complex. That's going to be on Tuesdays, October 7th and the 28th. And these classes, you get to use chalk dust. Yeah, so you can get really messy. That sounds like fun, doesn't it? So you might want to dress appropriately. Now, the class for ages 4 to 9 meets from 6:30 to 7:45 p.m., and then the class for ages 10 to 17 meet from 8 to 9. Now, cost is $12 per class, per child, and limited to the first 15 to register. So for more information to register for Art, Art, and More Art on Tuesday, October the 7th and the 28th at the Harrisburg Town Hall, just call 704-455-7275 or visit harrisburgnc.org.
Hey, David, do you remember a few weeks ago we were at Frank Lisk Park and we were trying.
Underline that in capitals, okay, Hannah? Trying.
To play disc golf.
Oh, yeah, that was...
Can you imagine if we tried to do it in the dark?
Like I said, I might be a little better at that because, you know, I'd just be throwing it, you know?
Disc golf can be tough enough, but try playing in the dark. The Terror Toss Disc Golf Tournament returns to Frank Lisk Park on Friday, October 17th. This 18-hole tournament is open to players of all skill levels. Skill, keyword skill.
Yeah, really.
And will start at sunset. Custom-stamped gloss discs will be included in the registration fees for all participants. Prizes will be awarded for first, second, and third place. The tournament costs $25 per team and increases to $35 if participants don't register by October 16th. The Terror Toss will be at Frank Lisk Park beginning at 6 p.m. on Friday, October 17th. To learn more information or to register, visit CabarrusCounty.us/reserve partner and put Terror Toss into the class search or call 704-920-3484.
Now, NASCAR fans, get ready for the weekend of fun. That's coming up at the Charlotte Motor Speedway. It's the return of the Bank of America 500. That's on Saturday, October the 11th. You start your weekend off Thursday night, October the 9th, as the stars of NASCAR hit the track to lay down the fastest lap times and land during the Bojangles pole night. Now, Friday night, the NASCAR Nationwide Series, they battle it out, the drivers do, in the NASCAR Nationwide Series 300. Now, on Saturday, October 11th, take place in NASCAR's one of its biggest events.
Oh, yeah.
The Bank of America 500. And only Saturday night race in the Chase. It's great to watch tonight. For more information on it or for tickets for the Bank of America 500 at 7:30 p.m. on Saturday, October the 11th, the Charlotte Motor Speedway, and all of the fun events associated with the 500, just visit charlottemotorspeedway.com. Or you can call them at 1-800-455-FANS.
If you love to run, like I do,
yes,
one of the area's favorite fall races is right around the corner. The Jack-O-Lantern Jaunt Road Race is Saturday, October 25th at Frank Lisk Park. The 1 mile fun run walk begins at 4:30 p.m. and the 5K starts at 5:30. You don't need to be a runner to enjoy the games and activities going on before and after the race. They include a mini golf tournament, Great Cabarrus County Pumpkin Carving Contest, Pumpkin Roll Obstacle Course, and a Jack-O-Lantern Jaunt Costume Contest. Once the sun goes down, there will be a glow mini golf tournament and dance with the Delmonicos.
Cool.
You can register online for the 5K at www.itsyourrace.com. The fee is $22.50. To learn more about the Jack-O-Lantern Jaunt Road Race on Saturday, October 25th at Frank Lisk Park, call 704-920-2701 or visit www.cabarruscounty.us/events.
Now, one of the most popular important classes offered by Cooperative Extension is the Beginning Beekeeper Series.
Oh.
Man, huge. It's kind of interesting. We did a David Gopher Successful Gardener on beekeeping.
Mm-hmm.
It's one of the highest views on YouTube that we have.
Really?
Yeah, there's a ton of people.
And I thought whenever I was on CTW.
That's second. Okay, you know. Hey, and when I was shooting the beekeepers, what you learn is very important in this class, because I didn't go to the class and I got too close to the bees, so that was not a good thing. So, the Certified Cabarrus County Association of Master Beekeepers, listen to them, will share information on bee anatomy, history, equipment, products involved with beekeeping. Now, participants will also learn how to get started in beekeeping, manage hives safely, very key.
Safely,
and how to think like a bee. Now, in addition, participants can learn how to retrieve and process honey from the hives, which is, hey, that's the payoff right there. Now, it may seem we're promoting this a little early, but the seats fill up fast. So registration is limited to only 60 individuals. So we want to make sure that CTW viewers get in there ahead of everybody else. So the class is appropriate for beginners and intermediates ages 16 and older. Cost of the class is only $43 and registration is required. So for more information or to register for the Beginning Beekeepers 2015 series, just call 704-920-3315 or visit online to cabarruscounty.us/reserve partner. Enter the search term bee. Now, I know we've had a lot of information on today's show, so if you missed any of the contact information, all you got to do is go to our web address, cabarruscounty.us, and right there in the search box, put in your topic, you find your information. Have any sort of problem, just shoot us an email at channel22cabarruscounty.us.
And we want you to sign up for the Cabarrus County e-newsletter. It's easy. Just go to cabarruscounty.us, visit the top right side of any page, and fill out a little information. It will come right to you. And remember to sign up for the county's Facebook and Twitter feeds. It's information that comes to you when you need it most. Find us at facebook.com/Cabarrus County and twitter.com/Cabarrus County.
And if you have family or friends that don't have Time Warner Cable, can't watch us on Channel 22, or maybe you just want to watch us when you have an opportunity, just go to cabarruscounty.us. Right there on the homepage, scroll down the lower left, you'll see a video screen. Right below it, it says More Channel 22 Programs. Click on that little button, all the thumbnails of all the different shows we do, and you can watch them on demand. And Laura, I wanted to thank you so much for helping us out the last month or so. It's been an absolute blast. I mean, we've had some cool adventures.
We've had a lot of fun. I've enjoyed every minute of it, David. And if you ever need me, just give me a call.
Well, I'm keeping my fingers crossed.
Please,
we can do that in the near future.
Okay, please.
All right. And until next week, you have a great one.
Thank you.